how should you make a product type? This is where it gets a little tricky, because I think there is a balance. I think there's a balance between having things be dynamically created as so keeping up with product types as new products come in and out, and then having like an ideal product type made, right? And so like looking back at QuadLock, let's say, again, they're not a client of ours. Let's say they're a client of ours. One of the things that we really like is like trying to get Shopify clients that we have over to the Simprosys app. You have to be careful with that. Maybe someday I'll walk through how to do a feed transition well, because it's very tricky and you got to be very careful. So be very cautious in doing that, because you could really impact performance and wipe out performance with a poorly done feed transition. You can even wipe out performance with a well done feed transition, frankly. It's tricky. But as we are able and when it makes sense, we do like to switch into Simprosys, because it's like this real cheap app. And one of the things that Simprosys does is it just pulls in your Shopify, you know, product types as your Google Merchant Center product types, which, by the way, that's actually confusing to me, that there's like product types in both of those ecosystems that actually mean different things. Well, it kind of means the same thing, but you know what I'm saying? It's describing different things. That can be a little tricky sometimes when you're communicating with your clients. Be aware of that. They use the same word. The problem with that is that those tend to be like single words. So in this case, you know, let's just say, and let's go ahead and walk this out a little bit. Let's say that we have marine, and then I must not be a boater, because like marine to me means like the military. It doesn't mean just like old Joe and his boat in the Minnesota lake over there. Anyways, from the mind of Kurt coming out at you there. Anyways, motorcycle, cycling, marine, and then like off-road, I think was the other one. So let's just roll with those four for now. So if you sync up, you know, your shopping, you should sync up your feed with Simprosys, and this happens with a lot of other apps too. It's not just Simprosys. This is probably going to turn into your product type. Now, here's the deal. There are times where we keep this as it is. One of those times may be like if we have a small budget client who has thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of products, because they have parts. So it's for a specific product, as well as all of the parts and accessories and all that, right? So thousands and thousands of products, but it's a very small budget client. And so it's not like financially worth it for them to have someone manually editing all of their product types. It's like the gain they have isn't, in my opinion at least, is not worth that, right? So that's in this is where we just use what we have in Simprosys, because also the other thing about that, when you have thousands and thousands of products, part of that is it's not just manual editing it the first time, right? Because we've done that. We've gone in and manually edited a ton of product types. It's that in a client like that, oftentimes you have new products that are entering all the time. And those would have to be constantly manually edited as well. So you actually need to have a system and process in place for your product types in order, when you have new products, to make sure if you have these custom, really well-created product types, if you have these custom product types, you actually have to make sure you keep up with that. You need a way, even if you are an in-house PPCer, you need a way to know from your team who is bringing in all these new products all the time. You need to know when a new product hits, right? So that you can go in and manual edit the product type and that sort of thing. So there's just a lot of stuff that goes into that. So there is actually an argument for maintaining your current product types, because they're dynamic. And when you get new products that enter into Shopify, they'll automatically be shifted into your right campaigns and that sort of thing. Because remember, if you're utilizing product types for campaigns and all of a sudden you have these new products coming in, they're not going to automatically shift into those. By the way, one way to account for that, that we always do, we did more in the old days, is we have an everything else ad group that we have where everything is excluded in the actual product types we're using. That way, if new products do get added, they get shifted into that everything else ad group. And then you, once that starts accruing costs, you're like, whoa, some new products got added, and you can go in. That's actually one way of catching that. So there's a tip for you. All that to say, what you might want to do with your team, internal team might actually, this is actually a good idea to me for even like updating your breadcrumbs on your site, right? But you might actually want to go in and create some cool product types around this. And here's where, like, let me just kind of give you an example of how you might think about this. So this is QuadLock, right? So this is QuadLock. They make cases. They make cases and mounts. Let's stick to those. So here's like number one, we kind of have to make some decisions right from the beginning. And that is, in my opinion, what is the main initial category that we have that we want to start with? And then where do we want to end? And this is an interesting, this QuadLock is an interesting one for me, because I can see two different things. I can see either starting with more of like let's say we add accessories, right, to all of these, and then eventually we end up at, you know, phone case and then phone mount, right? So it could be motorcycle accessories. It could be, actually, no, let me even put in, you could even, I mean, how far back do you want to start, right? You could go cycling accessories. Here, let me get some of that. Let me clear that a little bit so it's a little easier to kind of see. So cycling accessories, and then you could do phone mounts and cases. And then here's again where sometimes, so here's where you can get kind of creative, and I'm not sure where QuadLock, I don't think QuadLock has, I think the most of their cycling stuff is the same. But let's say they even made cases mounts that were different for road bikes and for mountain bikes. Cause those are very different. Those are very different cycling. I'm a road biker, not a mountain biker, right? Mountain biker, you have lots of jarring, that sort of thing. Road bike for the most part is like fairly smooth until you get hit by a car and then it's flying, right? Dark humor. So let's just say what we do is phone mounts and cases, and then we add in like road bike phone mounts. And so here's what I'm going to do. And then this would break into, and then you would actually put those products that would fit into there, if there are different ones. And then mountain bike phone mounts. And then we might do the same thing with the cases as well. Just the cases and then cases, right? And so all of a sudden, you have four very specific options here for, you know, for communicating to Google. Here's the only other thing, though, that you might not want to go this route. The other way that you could go to me would be starting more on the phone case side. So phones and accessories, phone mounts, and we do another one for cases, phone mounts, and then what we might do is cycling phone mounts, or I mean, heck, you could just go right to road bike phone mounts if you wanted, and then the same thing like with the cases and all that, right? But I would change this one as well. And then part of what that does, by the way, in your hierarchy, you also can get, and here's the other cool thing about product type, you can get some really cool reporting info that is very helpful to you within Google Ads. You can go into your Google Ads in your report section and like look in to see, okay, like How are phone cases compared? How are all phone cases compared to all phone mounts actually performing? You can see that once you have a really good product type system. So that's another reason I love product type, because of that. You know you can see the different layers of this and see at a really quick glance in the Google Ads report section, you can actually see where are people spending money in your business, in Google Ads on your category. So I think there's just a lot you can do with product type. And I guess, you know, the point of this video would just be like, encourage you to just kind of dig in on that, but definitely fill it out and then make sure. And you probably saw, like, I added in some descriptive stuff, and that is, you know, Google says, I forgot to note this. So the last thing I'll note is Google notes that having at least three tiers is ideal. So having at least three tiers suggests that it gives them better information for their algorithms. Tiers being this, here's one tier, two tiers. So in between the carrots, three. So this is a four tier product type. And then having like descriptive elements. So that's why I don't mind using cycling twice, frankly. And sometimes we'll utilize different words So, you know, this might be one we might do like this. Cycling and then bicycle accessories, right? And then phone mounts and cases and then road bike phone mounts. I mean, I'm probably overthinking a little bit, but what I've found over the years, like here's three different synonyms for bike right in our product types, right? And so I've just found over the years, like, it's just helpful to be really descriptive with these sort of things. This is what I think about product titles and descriptions too, by the way. Super descriptive. Get in some more of those terms. Communicate to Google. This is what it's about. It's not just accessories. Like, it's not just cycling and then accessories. It's cycling and then it's bicycle accessories. It's road bike phone mounts, you know, all that stuff. That also gives Google, like, better contextual information. It's almost, I think of it almost like keyword stuffing, frankly. And still a good idea to pursue, in my opinion, at least. That's a lot of product type information. That's actually longer. This was actually a longer video than I intended to do. So I hope it's super valuable to you. Please definitely let me know if you have questions in the comments. I'm really going to start. I commit to you to doing a better job this year. All right. That's like my Boy Scout commitment. I commit to doing a better job at Merchant Center Mastery. I really want to get this channel and invest more effort into giving you helpful information. So leave questions, leave ideas. I like having ideas for what videos to shoot as well, because right now it's just kind of like from the mind of Kirk, whatever I come up with and think of. So ideas would be awesome. I'm just going to keep trucking along with this, working at it. And thanks for joining me on that journey. And let's learn Google Merchant Center together a little bit better. Thank you.